Now, Javad Javadi, or Mr. Chef, as you know him, has asked me to talk about going to Iran. And I kind of don't even really know how to talk about it. I've been three times. First time, I went to Tehran, Shiraz, Esfahan. Tehran is like, it's big. It's big and it's crowded, sometimes dirty. But I've been to New York before, and when you go to New York, you walk out into the street from where you're staying and you get wrapped up in this energy. And the same thing happens in Tehran. You walk out of your apartment where you're staying and all of a sudden there's things happening all over the place. And it's fantastic. It's fantastic. I've always felt really safe in Tehran. Because I think it's because I'm Australian, I'm a bit cheeky. And so, like, I walk along the street and people, every so often, someone will stare at you a little bit too much. And I'll say, g'day. And you see this look of confusion across their face and then a big smile. And it's, I love that. The Persians kind of, when I've been in Iran, the Persians, they, when you first meet them, they're very kind of, and then you break the ice and it's beautiful. And I've been to a lot of places in Iran. I've been to places that a lot of Iranians have said that they haven't been to. Last time I went to Kandavan, which was, go up to Tabriz, turn left. And Kandavan's this little village. I don't know how many people live there, probably 1,000 or 2,000. And it's built into rocks. The houses are built into rocks. I have no idea why people lived there to start off with, because it's kind of harsh. You have to walk up kind of quite steep steps, very good for your thighs and very good for your butt. And I had one of the best meals that I've ever had in Iran, which was this breakfast, and it was a traditional Persian breakfast. Oh, what's the name of the bread?
Sangyuk.
Sanga?
Yep.
And local honey and local cream, fresh tomatoes and fresh boiled eggs. And it was absolutely simple and it was absolutely delicious. It was fantastic. When I go to Iran, I've got a couple of friends in Tehran now, and we go for a road trip. And we've gone for a road trip every time that I've been. And it's fantastic because you get to see things that you don't get to see otherwise. So there'll be, So I've been to towns like Abiyane, which was this fantastic village. Yes, and just one of the things that I didn't know about Iran, and this is coming, you know, I live in Australia, I've lived in Australia all my life. With the Iran-Iraq war, I would know, heard about it on the news, but didn't pay much attention. It didn't kind of interest me or affect me that much. And I didn't realise how important that war was and how much of an impact it still has. And it kind of struck me in a town like Abiyane, where there would be a few hundred people that live there, and the pictures of the martyrs. And the number of young men that died in that war from that village, and it was shocking and incredibly sad. And I know that there's issues. I just found that kind of quite confronting. It was an interesting place. Now, my best meal in Iran, there's too many to talk about. Esfahan, with that absolutely brilliant bazaar. I've forgotten what it's called. What's the bazaar in Isfahan called?
I didn't know, sorry.
Oh, I can't believe you. What kind of Persian? But it's, I can't remember the name.
Bazaar.
Bazaar. No, bazaar. Yeah, but it's got the name. It's the name. It's the place where you, if you stay long enough, you meet one half of the world. And it's spectacular. Kind of, you know, you walk into the bazaar and it's breathtaking. The beauty and the size, absolutely fantastic. And I think it's Shahrazad?
Shahrazad.
There's a restaurant in Isfahan, quite a famous one. Go upstairs, my mate, my buddy in Iran, Millard, would always manage to kind of get us a good table. And last time I went there, I had this fish, it was a fish kebab, absolutely fantastic. But then there was, on the side of the dish, there was a vegetable, and it was coriander and cumin, and it was braised. And I had never heard of that combination. I could never imagine that combination. And it was spectacular. It was so beautiful, and I can taste it now. And Javed has asked me to say that, you know, one of the things that I didn't know about was the hospitality of Iranians. And there's a warning, you need to be really careful about being invited to people's houses because they will feed you almost until you're dead. And the kind of warmth and embrace that people do is, I find, extraordinary. And I think it's, you know, because you do, you know, the media stuff about Iran and all of that kind of falafel, kind of, you forget that there's people behind there and that, yeah, I've just found, you know, the greatest risk in being invited to an Iranian's family's house is to be able to leave on your own two legs, because they'll stuff you with food and you will not be able to kind of get out easily. Listen, there's other foods that I've had there. There's, I went to a village outside Ilam and visited the family of a Persian friend here, cousins, and they slaughtered a sheep, a lamb for me when I came to visit. And it was, the food was spectacular. It was so, the kebab that they made out of it. And I kind of really admire the fact that Iranians will use everything. They will use all of the sheep. And we'll talk about kalapache.
Yeah.
But I was kind of thinking, you know, the sheep's intestine, liver, all of that stuff, kebab on a kebab and barbecued is spectacular. And I had never had meat so fresh there before. It was fantastic. And I was thinking kalapache is this kind of dare that Iranians have of Anglo-Saxons. It's kind of like they don't think we're strong, you know, that we don't, that, yeah, they think we get scared. And you know, I love kalapache. I love it. I can't have too much of it. I know, because I feel, you know, you eat a bit of kalapache in the morning and it keeps you going for the rest of the day. I was also thinking, oh, Tajrish, going up, walking up Valley Asa to Tajrish, and having halim and ashrishte. What's the, and there's a really famous kind of ashrishte halim shop in Tajrish near the bazaar.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, it's fantastic. And I have to go there every time that I go to Iran. The visit has to include halim and ashrishte from that shop. Also, one of the things that's kind of changed over the last couple of years is the availability of coffee and the development of coffee shops in Iran. So there's this fantastic coffee. There's a couple of coffee shops that are just brilliant in Tehran that I've been to. One of them's the it's Sam Cafe in Parkway near Valley Asa. The coffee is Kelly Koshmazer, Fantastic. Yeah, and it's kind of funny because it's in, you know, the north of Tehran, and there's far too much plastic surgery. So there's a whole lot of women, you know, with ridiculous kind of cheekbones, absolutely unnatural noses, huge lips, you know, kind of sipping coffee without moving their face at all. It's fantastic. But the coffee, you know, but they, you know, they may be completely, have completely plastic faces, but they've got good taste in coffee. The coffee is fantastic. Another thing about Tehran that I was really surprised is the spirit of the place. Like, there's a lot of young people there, and they've got balls. They're really kind of, there's a really interesting kind of street culture there that happens. And it's interesting being in a very conservative kind of environment, how people rebel. And the young people do it really, really well. The arts scene is really surprising. I went to the Contemporary Art Museum, and there was an exhibition on that was really kind of quite boring, but there were some pieces of art that had been collected by the Shah's wife, Farah Diba. And, you know, those art pieces of artwork from the 1960s and 70s were absolutely fantastic. And the last time I went to a concert in Saadabad Palace, in the grounds of Saadabad Palace. And it was, I don't know the name of it, Homayun was playing, and it was a kind of traditional Persian story. And the Persians will know it. No, I'm sorry that I can't think of what it's called. But it was this absolutely beautiful night, sitting in a park, on chairs in a park. There were a few thousand people there watching this performance, singing and music, a musical performance. Spectacular. The other thing that I love about Tehran is the mountains around Tehran. There's mountains to the north of Tehran, and they're gigantic. And they always, whenever I see them, it always reminds me of your kind of that the mountains win. That they're absolutely beautiful, and they surround Tehran, and it's kind of like it's a barrier to the world, but it's also this kind of natural environment that reminds you that you are just a human being. And going up those mountains is fantastic. Going to Tehran Ban is wonderful. And I'll say, oh God, that food on the way to the mountains, you know, Darakesh and Daband and all those places. Iranians do know how to kind of live very nicely. You know, that kind of lying around, getting completely fat on, you know, shishlik and kebab and juja and blah, blah, blah. It's fantastic. In this really kind of beautiful environment. And I've mostly been in Tehran in summer, so it's been really hot. But in the kind of restaurants, the outdoor restaurants in Darband, and, you know, they kind of spray this mist of water over you to keep you cool, and it's just delicious. Fantastic.